I cannot believe the Chiefs couldn't even score a touchdown. What stood out to you about the game?
Well, Don, first of all, good morning. I hope you enjoyed the game. And what stood out to me was the two black coordinators, and Byron Leftwich and Todd Bowles, Temple guy, may I say, Temple TU representing in the Super Bowl last night. But, you know, listen, those two guys really outdid themselves. They stopped Patrick Mahomes. They stopped Tariq Hill. They stopped the Super Bowl defending champions, former the Super Bowl defending champions now and the Chiefs. I thought Todd Bowles' plan, you know, to stay back and beat those guys up front was just brilliant. Byron Leftwich called a great game. And you know, listen, you cannot go against Tom Brady. You know, I was telling my boss, Jeff McCracken, that when he was on Slack and talking, who are we going to pick? I said, listen, you can't go against a guy like Tom Brady. You know, people are going to love Joe Montana. People are going to love all the great quarterbacks. I wasn't around to see a lot of them, but I am around to see Tom Brady. And I got to say, this guy's the GOAT. Now, I'm saying this, and Peyton Manning's my favorite quarterback of all time, but Tom Brady, you can't knock what he did. He took the Tampa Bay Buccaneers the first year in that place to the Super Bowl, the first team to represent themselves in the Raymond James Stadium at home, playing a home game for a Super Bowl, and he did it. And he did it, and he beat out Bill Belichick. I'm sure he loved that. Rob Gronkowski. It was a great game last night for me from a competitive standpoint, and watching, you know, Brady and Mahomes go at it. You know, you're looking at past and present, right? Mahomes is the future king, but until he gets that crown from Tom Brady, right now he's just the prince. Tom Brady's still the king as long as he's playing.
So Jabari, you know, I grew up in the Niners era back in the 80s and early 90s when they were huge. And of course, I'm a Joe Montana and Jerry Rice fan. We saw Tom Brady and Rob Gronkowski break the all-time postseason record for QB receiver touchdown receptions. How big of a deal is it that the fact that Tom Brady can reunite with Rob Gronkowski, two former Patriots, now doing it together and winning a championship in Tampa Bay?
I mean, listen, that was a fun story and certainly a part of it. You know, Gronkowski hitting for two touchdowns, Antonio Brown, after everything that man's went through, even making his presence felt in the Super Bowl. And again, I just thought it was a competitive, nobody expected, Dom, but we were talking on Friday, we didn't expect that the Bucs will beat the Chiefs by this much. I had at least like a 3 to 4 point game. But, you know, all around, it was just great. I mean, and you know, Brady just displayed his greatness, whether it's connected with Gronkowski, whether it's connected with Mike Evans, whether it's connected with any of his receivers out there. You know, it was a reason why he's crowned MVP. The man just continues to do it time and time again on the biggest stage of the NFL, and that's the Super Bowl. I mean, listen, 7-5 MVPs. What more can you say about that? And I know, Dom, you're a Joe Montana guy, maybe. And I know a lot of people are Joe Montana guys. A lot of people are Dan Marino, Brett Favre, all the greats. But you cannot put Tom Brady underneath any of those guys. I think he's number one. And again, Peyton's my favorite quarterback. But it was just good to see that last night, to see somebody of that age do that at the highest of levels. I mean, you don't see that very much in sports, especially a 40-plus-year-old guy.
Tom Brady, as the greatest of all time, used to be an opinion. It's becoming more fact with the numbers starting to back it up now, Jabari. Yeah. I also want to bring up Sarah Thomas, Lori Locust, Maral Javadafar, the three ladies who made a big impact on the Super Bowl last night. Sarah Thomas, again, trying to officiate a game. She did for the first time ever as a female official. The other two as assistant coaches for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and winning a championship. How big of a deal was that for gender equality in sports?
You know, it's a very big deal. Anytime that you see female involvement in male-dominated sports, I mean, it's just always good. I have a 7-year-old daughter, and though she doesn't necessarily like football that much, when she gets to look at the screen and she, you know, she's seeing her dad watching football and she sees a girl on that screen, she gets to point them out and says, "Dad, who's that?" And I think that starts the conversation of getting younger females involved in football in any sport. You know, I think, you know, obviously we could talk about Tom Brady all day, right? We could talk about the fact that the Super Bowl was first in history of being the way it is because of the pandemic, only a certain amount of people there, the mask all over the place. And I hope that, you know, once it's all said and done, that those things that you mentioned, those three females that you mentioned, I hope that doesn't go under the radar, because that was a big moment, especially for Sarah Thomas last night for the NFL, to see that female representation on the highest stage of the NFL, and that's the Super Bowl. So it was great to see for me.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.